The partial government shutdown entering its third day, with a source telling CNN that little progress was made over the weekend toward ending the impasse over President Trump's demand for border wall funding.
It's very possible that the shutdown will go beyond the 28th and into the new Congress.
The White House backing off of their request for $5 billion, but continuing to insist that funding for the wall be included in any agreement.
We moved off of the five. We hope they move up from their 1.3.
It will never pass the Senate. Not today, not next week, not next year. So, Mr. President, President Trump, if you want to open the government, you must abandon the wall. Plain and simple.
A source says that after President Trump rejected a short-term bipartisan deal to keep the government open last week, Senate Minority Leader Chuck Schumer countered by offering more money for border security, that offer also rebuffed. Vice President Pence later offering his own counteroffer that was dismissed by Schumer. President Trump turning to Twitter to insist that a wall is the only solution.
It really is in the president's hands to decide. He says it's an issue of border security. I think we know better. It's an issue of his own political insecurity. When the right wingers start screaming at him, he just backs off and dissembles in front of us.
Lawmakers on both sides of the aisle trading jabs on the Sunday shows, with some conservative Republicans urging the president to stay the course, as others in the GOP struggled to defend the shutdown.
It's a spectacle, and candidly, it's juvenile.
We have an impulsive president, we know that, and it's completely taking away a focus from where it should be on a very, very strong economy.
Approximately 800,000 federal employees are impacted, including more than 420,000 who are working without pay during the shutdown, and another 380,000 who've been furloughed. Meantime, there is more turmoil in the Trump administration. The president abruptly pushing Defense Secretary James Mattis out of his position earlier than expected, replacing Mattis temporarily with his current deputy and former Boeing executive Patrick Shanahan. Sources tell CNN that the president only realized how critical Mattis's resignation letter was after announcing that he was retiring with distinction, and that he's grown increasingly angry watching lawmakers lament Mattis's departure and criticize the troop drawdown on the news.